Hey, I'm Justin Fisher in the Shape Your Future Healthy Kitchen. I'm with Chef Valerie from OUTU School of Community Medicine. First of all, I've watched a lot of these segments. I'm finally getting to meet you, so it's an honor.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah. So, glad
you're here.
Also, you're talking about almost all of my favorite things. Peanut butter,
good.
Oats, honey, and we're putting it in something that really doesn't take a lot of time, because not everybody has a lot of time to do this. You don't have to bake it at all, either. And you just eat it, which I can't wait to do. But show us how kind of the steps we're going through.
Yeah, so in our pan already, I mean, this is like a super easy, as you mentioned, little recipe. So we have some peanut butter, some honey, and we're gonna put in some rolled oats. And then that mixture is just gonna go into our already lined sheet pan, or excuse me, Pyrex container. Mm-hmm. And we're just gonna go ahead and put this right in here. And this is gonna be a great snack. So instead of like a peanut butter cup, a Reese's peanut butter cup for Halloween coming up, we're gonna do something a little bit, preservatives and some weird chemicals that maybe you don't know what those things mean, I don't. So we're just gonna get this all in here and then you're going to mash it down. But in the meantime, we have yet more peanut butter in our little saucepan, some chocolate chips. So I'm gonna continue kind of mashing this down. So you're gonna get kind of a flat layer. Mm-hmm. And then something that you've told me that you actually like sun butter.
Yes, because I have just spoonfuls of peanut butter. Kind of hurt your stomach a little bit. So my sister actually told me about sunflower butter, which sounds a little weird, but when they put it in there, it tastes very similar to peanut butter. Just as good, a little bit healthier for you as well.
Yeah. And so if you have kids or adults with peanut butter allergy in your home, obviously that is an excellent alternative to that. Okay, so if we had a little more time, we would smooth this out just a little bit.
It looks great just as it is.
Yeah. So this is almost a chocolate sauce that we're gonna pour on top. So it's gonna be our chocolate topping.
That looks amazing. And that just goes on top of this little mixture you got here?
Yes. And so the whole thing is gonna go into the freezer for 45 minutes to firm up.
Really quick then.
Yeah, really quick. And then once you pull it out and it can sit at room temperature and that chocolate will stay solid so you don't have to keep it refrigerated or frozen. You can see that we have just a few seconds left on those chocolate chips. But we're gonna go ahead and
pour peanut butter in there for a little bit getting warm.
Yeah, just warm enough to melt that chocolate. Goes right on top. I don't know if you all can see that or not.
Oh, I can tell you. It looks amazing. Yeah, there we go. That's a beautiful shot of it.
Okay, so this just gets smoothed around.
And this is kind of a good idea, too, if maybe you're going to a party, you have somebody coming out for Halloween, something like that, really quick. Maybe you forgot to do something. Have the candy ready.
And this is a great one for the kids to help with, too, because obviously they love these ingredients, and everybody likes to have a little sweet treat, and it's super easy, super safe in the kitchen. So anyway, this is your finished product.
45 minutes freezer.
Yep.
Comes out just like this. I know we cut this up a little bit earlier. It looks like diamonds I really like, and I'm gonna try it because I love peanut butter. But seriously, if you don't or you're allergic to it, sunflower butter is the way to go. All right, here we go. I was worried it would be too much peanut butter, but it's very, very light. Has the good oats, a little bit of chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
Mike, I like that. All right. Well, of course, you can see all these recipes and many more over on KJRH.com. Thank you, Chef Fowl. Thank you all for watching.
Thank you.